So we're privileged to have number 10 Brock Palmer coming and visit with us during the first period of intermission. Kind of surprised not to see you on the ice in such an important game, but everybody gets a turn, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So Brock, I always ask the first question is, as a Dynamiter, how did you get here? Where are you from? What position do you play? What's your number?
Well, I got here. I went to Drumheller Dragons main camp. Earlier in the year, and I got released from there, and I called Derek Stewart, and he said he'd be happy to have me here, so it was awesome. I'm from Lethbridge, Alberta, Coaldale, Alberta, I guess, and last year I played Midget AAA in Lethbridge.
Okay, and obviously number 10 is your number.
Yeah.
You're one of the leading scorers on the club. What is it about Junior B hockey and the Dynamiters that allows you to do what you need to do to get goals?
I think it's awesome here. Derek and Kievers and all the other coaching staff let me have freedom in my game of play, not so structured, and I can be creative in the offensive zone and other places in the ice as well.
Okay. What, other than putting the puck in the net, which you've done on a fairly consistent basis this year, what do you think that your best attribute is as far as a Dynamiter is concerned?
Well, I definitely think I have to contribute to the team offensively, and if I'm not contributing offensively, then I'm not contributing necessarily at all. So I have to definitely keep doing well in the offensive zone, and not turn over pucks in the defensive zone.
Okay. Every hockey player has challenges and things they need and want to work on. What's your number one work on?
I think I need to work on not so much on the ice but off the ice and getting stronger and going to the gym so I don't get knocked off pucks as easy. And I can stay stronger, hold on to the puck, and not fall over as much.
Okay. What are your thoughts on tonight's hockey game so far?
It's been awesome so far. We've been doing well. Power play's been good. And that's awesome for Cam Russell to grind in that goal.
One thing the Dynamiters look like they're doing quite a bit is getting traffic in front of Mitchell.
Yes.
He's one of the top goalies in the league, so that's obviously something you need to do.
Yeah, for sure. He's a really good goalie. And we were lucky to have the backup goalie in the last night. We won in overtime. Obviously, he played good that game as well. But, this goalie is definitely really, really good.
You've got a very experienced defensive core behind you and
from the forward line.
What kind of a communication do you have with them trying to get that puck out of the zone and into the offensive zone?
It's awesome that we have such a great defensive core. It's really easy. First pass out of the zone is always great from the defense up to the winger. So once I get the puck on the wall, it's easy to get out with the first pass.
Okay. Every hockey player has a role model, a hero, if you will. Who would you like to pattern your game after? Who is your hockey hero?
My hockey hero is Tyler Johnson from the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Okay.
He's a small guy. He's not left-handed. He's right-handed. But I look up to him and kind of watch video on him and how he plays.
Okay. Hockey goals. Any?
Well, from here, I would try hopefully to get a scholarship to a school either in the States or, I don't know, just a school, I guess, and be able to play hockey during post-secondary.
Okay. So, as a midget player last year, you're obviously not 21 years old, so how old are you, and are you going to school here in Kimberley?
I'm 18 years old, and I'm just working at the Kimberley Aquatic Center right now.
Okay.
I'm not going to school or anything like that, taking a year off.
All right.
Yeah.
Looking at the town of Kimberley, I know you called Derek to see if there might be a spot here for you, and obviously there is, and I think the Dynamiters are happy that you're here. What can you tell me about your perception of the town and the Kimberley fans?
It's awesome. Yeah, living here, well, I've never lived anywhere else in BC, but this is definitely a really, really nice place to live. The mountains are awesome. The people are awesome. The town's awesome. Yeah, I love it here.
Other than hockey, do you have any other interests?
I played high school badminton. I play soccer in the off season to keep me in shape, kind of thing, and I enjoy it as well. Other than that, not too much.
Okay. Looking at going to school or and getting a scholarship, hopefully that's something that's going to happen. Mm-hmm. What kind of things would you study and what would your life goal be?
I'm not 100% sure yet. My mind's kind of been back and forth. I think an elementary school teacher would be pretty cool. But yeah, I definitely still got to think about it.
So education is kind of one choice.
Yeah, definitely.
Let's talk about your billet parents. Who are you billeting with and what's that like?
I'm billeting with Mike and Carol Flowers. Well, I guess I'm living at Mike's house.
Yeah. Okay. And last but not least, any shout-outs to those that might be watching tonight?
Well, my mom and dad are up in the stands tonight, so it's awesome to have them here. And we have some family friends here as well, so it's nice to see them.
So everybody that might be watching is already watching here in the arena.
Yeah, they're in the arena.
So. All right. Thanks, Brock, for coming in. Appreciate your time.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Good luck for the rest of the season.
Sweet. Thank you.
Number 10, Brock Palmer.